Monish Gambia hasn't looked back since he changed careers 4 years ago. When the GP of 15 years moved to Australia, he retrained as a disability support worker.
Hello, Anton. Hi, can I get in? How are you?
Eager to help people achieve their goals.
What are we doing today?
It's a wonderful feel when you are useful to people and your job is not only just for the money you want to earn, it's giving you fulfillment and, you know, that happy feel when, you know, it's making a difference to other people.
This is a fun thing for you, right? But you have to be safe.
The NDIS is expected to be one of the largest job creation opportunities in Australia's history. And people are making the switch from hospitality, car manufacturing, and even driving taxis to disability support.
So you're having a ride.
Much of the work is highly skilled, requiring extensive training, understanding and compassion.
We need a lot of fresh ideas and enthusiastic people coming into the industry.
What are we doing? Are we doing the chocolate cake today? Let's get started.
Right. If a right support and a care can be given, it really changes their life.
Anton Sugrillo feels well supported with his regular paid carers, but says there are still gaps in the system.
Thank you.
Little heart, sometimes agency don't understand my routine. I need somebody to listen to me and be reliable. Respectful to me, my home, and my choices.
In recent years, the workforce has grown by up to 14% a year, but will need to double by 2023 to keep up with demand. That's roughly an additional 90,000 full-time jobs.
At any given time, there are hundreds of job vacancies in Australia, yet there are too few people willing to study to become a support worker.
Disability rights advocates say it's not uncommon for a person to go without essential support because a shift couldn't be filled, or filled by an adequately trained worker.
With a big focus on increasing the quantity of the workforce, in some cases it's come at the expense of quality. Complaints about disability services have skyrocketed almost 90% in South Australia in the past 2 years. And the complexity of those complaints has also increased.
So it's not just through overt and horrific cases of abuse that people with disability are endangered. It can be negligence through lack of training and lack of confidence in support workers to carry out really good quality care.
Advocates want people with disability to be better respected and say that also means giving more support to the workers.
Part of that involves supporting disability sector support workers to know the rights of people with disability and to stand up for the rights of people with disability, to stand up for their own working conditions and to advocate for the training that they need to carry out support in a way that's safe and best practice. Because a person that is confident to act is likely to act, and that is going to contribute to better safeguard people with disability as well.
It's going well. Look at the colour. Looks nice. Should we do it with the mixer?
Yeah.
Already.
Because not every person with disability has someone like Monish Gambia in the mix.
Monish understands me. Monish is careful and patient. A good worker supports me, keep me safe. Listen carefully. Understand it's my needs.
Chocolatey. It'll be yum.
The recipe for a more inclusive, safer future.
Let's go in that one.
Claire Campbell, ABC News, Adelaide.
Wonderful.